In this video, we are going to revise the type of polarization. So what is the type of polarization? The polarization of light wave describes the shape and focus of the tip of the E vector in the plane perpendicular to the direction of propagation at a given point in space as a function of time. Depending upon the locus of the tip of the E vector, light may exhibit three different states of polarizations. Number one, plane or linear polarization. Number two, elliptical polarization. And number three, circular polarization. Apart from these, the light may also be partially polarized. So, E vector ke tip ko dekhte hue, lights पोलराइजेशन को हम लोग तीन कैटेगरी में डिवाइड करते हैं, प्लेन और लीनियर पोलराइजेशन, नंबर टू इलेप्टिकल पोलराइजेशन और नंबर थ्री सर्कुलर पोलराइजेशन। इस तीनों के अलावा लाइट हमारा पार्शियली पोलराइज्ड भी होता है। अब आते हैं नंबर वन, प्लेन पोलराइज्ड लाइट। व्हाट इज प्लेन पोलराइज्ड लाइट? प्लेन पोलराइज्ड लाइट वेव आर द लाइट वेव्स इन विच ऑक्सीडेशंस ऑकर इन ए सिंगल प्लेन। इन ए प्लेन पोलराइज्ड वेव, polarized wave, the oscillation of the electric field vector E are strictly confined to a single plane perpendicular to the direction of propagation. एक ही plane पे propagation होता है. As the direction of the field vector at a some point in a space and the time lies along the line in a plane perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation, the plane polarized wave is also known as linearly polarized wave. Plane polarized light को इसलिए हम लोग linear polarized light भी कहते हैं. With linear polarization, the orientation of E vector always stays constant at a point in a space, that is, direction of E does not vary with time, but its magnitude varies sinusoidally with the field as pointing. मतलब E vectors का जो है वो orientation change नहीं होता है, but इसका magnitude जो है वो change होता है sinusoidally. At the tip of the down, it is called vertical polarization, or if the pointing either right or left, it is called horizontal polarization. कैसे? अगर इसका tip जो है वो up and down हो, तो उसको हम लोग vertical polarization कहेंगे. और इसका अगर पॉइंटिंग आइदर राइट और लेफ्ट हो, तो इसको हम लोग हॉरिजॉन्टल पोलराइजेशन कहेंगे. ये एक प्लेन पोलराइजेशन वेव का फिगर है, जिसमें हम लोग देख रहे हैं कि इसका जो मैग्नीट्यूड है वो साइन वेव के रिस्पेक्ट में चेंज कर रहा है. डायरेक्शन सेम है, लेकिन मैग्नीट्यूड इसका चेंज करेगा, एंड इट इज द प्लेन ऑफ पोलराइजेशन. सो इफ एक्स इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ट्रेवल ऑफ द लाइट, वाई एंड जेड बी द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द प्लेन ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड मेक्स एन कॉन्स्टेंट एंगल टू द जेड डायरेक्शन. द वेव इन द फिगर थ्री इज द रिजल्टेंट वेव ड्यू टू द सुपर पोजिशन ऑफ टू कोहरेंट लीनियरली पोलराइज्ड वेव ऑक्सिलेटिंग इन फेज. So representation of linear polarized light in the diagram, this is the representation of linearly polarized light. So when the electric field vector oscillates horizontal in that direction, so it is horizontal direction mein jab ye move karega, horizontal in direction, it direction perpendicular to the plane of paper light are being represented by dots. And the, when the electric field vector oscillates vertically in the plane of paper, the light wave is represented by arrows. Ye arrows hum log yahan pe denote karte hain. So next हमारा है circularly polarized light. So a light wave is said to be a circularly polarized if the course of the wave propagation, the magnitude of the electric vector E stays constant, but it rotates at a constant rate about the direction of propagation and sweeps a circular helix in a space shown in the figure. इस तरह से movement करते हुए आगे की ओर बढ़ेगा. This is the form of an helix. This is the picture of in terms of space variation of vector E. In the circularly polarized light, there is a no preference of a specific direction of oscillation. The circularly polarized light wave may be regarded as the resultant of wave produced due to the superposition of two coherent linearly polarized wave of equal amplitude, oscillating in mutually perpendicular planes and are out of phases by 90 degrees. So this is the diagram of the two superposition of two waves which are coherent in nature and which is mutually perpendicular to 90 degrees. This is the circularly polarized wave, is a combination of horizontally and vertically polarized light. This is the horizontal and the vertical polarization. So if we stand at a one point in a space, if we stand in one point in space and look at the direction of wave, we will observe that the E vector sweeps a circle. Hence, it is called circularly polarized wave. Here, the oscillations of the resultant E vector do not take place in the single plane. Next is types of polarization, circular polarization. If the rotation of the tip of E is clockwise, as seen by an observer looking back towards the source, then the wave is said to be right circularly polarized. And if the tip of the E rotates anticlockwise, then the wave is said to be left circularly polarized. These are the examples of right circularly polarization and the left circularly polarization. Number three is elliptically polarized light. So the light wave is said to be elliptically polarized if the magnitude of the electric vector E changes with the time and the vector E rotates about the direction of propagation, sweeps at a flattened helix in a space. This is the description of elliptically polarized light in the terms of space variation of E. So it is the form of helix. It is the flattened helix. This is the light wave having vector E. This is the direction X. The space variation E, E sweeps out a flattened helix in the space. So elliptically polarized light wave may be regarded as the resultant wave produced due to the superposition of two coherent linearly polarized waves of different amplitude, oscillating in mutually perpendicular planes and are out of phase. Circular polarized light में हमारा क्या था कि 90 degree phase में था, 90 degree mutually perpendicular था, यहाँ पे out of phase है. If the wave of differing amplitudes are related to phases by 90 degree or if the related phases difference other than 90 degree, then the resultant light wave is elliptically polarized. So this is an example, a diagram of elliptically polarized light. So it is the elliptic polarized wave in the combination of horizontal polarized and vertically polarized wave that are different amplitude and are out of phase by theta degree. So the types of elliptically polarized light is when we are looking back towards the source, if the rotation of E vector occur clockwise, it is said to be right elliptically polarized wave. And if the rotation in the anticlockwise direction, it is said to be a left elliptically polarized wave. Apart from plane polarized light, number two, circularly polarized light, and number last, the elliptically polarized light, there is also a term which defines the partially polarized light. So what is partially polarized light? Usually the light is neither totally polarized nor unpolarized, but it is a mixture of two types, that is the combination of polarized and unpolarized light. It can be viewed as a mixture of two types, that is plane polarized light and a unpolarized light. So partially polarized light is represented as this form. Partially polarized light, like natural light, can be represented in the form of superposition of two incoherent plane polarized waves with mutually perpendicular planes of oscillations. In the case of natural light, the amplitude of these waves is same, and for partially polarized light it is different. So this is the types of polarization. Next is, what is the degree of polarization? If we pass partially polarized light through a polarizer, and if we rotate the polarizer about the direction of ray, the intensity of the transmitted light will change within the limits from I max, that is maximum value to minimum value, I minimum. So the degree of polarization with the help of following expression will be P is equal to I max minus I minimum divided by I max plus I minimum. And the percentage of polarization is equal to I max minus I minimum, I max plus I minimum, that is the polarization into 100. And the last, for a plane polarized light, if I minimum is equal to 0 and P and percentage polarization is 100 degree, while for the natural light, I max is equal to I minimum, P is equal to 0 and percentage of polarization is equal to 0. While for if I max is equal to 2 times of I minimum, then value of P, that is polarization, is equal to 0.33 and percentage of polarization is equal to 100 divided by 3, that is 33%. The concept of degree of polarization, the concept of degree of polarization cannot be applied to the elliptically and circularly polarized light. Now the next is the production of plane polarized light. Plane polarized light ko hum log produce kaise karte hain? So plane polarized light may be produced from the unpolarized light using the following 5 optical phenomena. Number 1, reflection. Number 2, refraction. Number 3, scattering of light. Number 4, selective absorption, that is called discrolsums. And number 5 is double refraction. Out of these 5, the phenomena of selective absorption is number 4 and the double reflection are helpful in practical production of plane polarized light. In this chapter, we will study double reflection ke bare mein jyada hum log padhenge. Now next is the polarization by reflection from dielectric surfaces. Do alag alag surfaces pe polarization kis tarah se kaam karta. So by the scientist E.L. Moll and the friend, which is the, he was a French engineer, discovered in 1808 that polarization of a light by a refraction. He noticed that when a natural light is incident on a smooth surface, jab koi natural light smooth surface pe incident hota hai at a certain angle, the reflected beam is plane polarized. Reflected beam jo hota hai, wo plane polarized hota hai. The extent to which the polarization occurs is depending upon the angle at which the light incident. The polarization ka jo value hoga wo incident angle pe depend karega. And upon the material which is the surface is made of, aur jis material ka wo surface bana hua us material pe wo depend karta hai. Metallic surfaces reflect light with a variety of variational directions, such as reflected light is unpolarized. However, light that is spatially reflected from dielectric surfaces such as asphalt, roadways, water, etc. is linearly polarized. If we extend the linear polarization is large, a person receives glare from such surfaces. When light waves is incident on boundary between two dielectric materials, part of it is reflected and part of it is transmitted. So here there are two figure, figure 1 and figure 2. This is the interface of two medium, that is air and glass. Light, unpolarized light beam is incident and a part of it is reflected and some of part is transmitted. This is the angle of refraction. This is reflected beam partially polarized. Reflected beam partially polarized, it is unpolarized beam. And this is the second figure, which is unpolarized incoming beam incident at angle Bleuster angle. Iske bare mein hum log abhi discuss karenge. Reflected angle, polarized reflected beam C, air and glass ka ye interface hai, and the transmitted wave is partially polarized reflected beam. So figure 1A, this is the figure 1A, shows an unpolarized light beam AB incident on a glass surface. The incident ray AB and the normal NB and S define the plane of incidence. The electric vector E of the ray AB can be resolved into two components, one perpendicular to the plane of incidence, another is lying in the plane of incidence. The perpendicular component of represented by the dots and called the S component. And next is the component, parallel component of represented by the arrows, and it is called P components. In case of completely unpolarized light, the two components are equal magnitude एट ए पर्टिकुलर एंगल थीटा पी, दैट इज ब्रूस्टर एंगल, द रिफ्लेक्शन कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ पी कंपोनेंट गोज टू जीरो एंड द रिफ्लेक्टेड बीम डज नॉट कम टू पी कंपोनेंट, इट इज शोन इन द फिगर 1p. सो इट इज कंटेन ओनली s कंपोनेंट एंड इट इज टोटली प्लेन पोलराइज्ड. If the angle theta b is here, the angle theta b is called polarizing angle or Brewster angle. So next article में हम लोग देखेंगे कि what is Brewster angle, how scientist Brewster is defined Brewster angle, and what is the main purpose of defining Brewster angle in terms of polarization and other optical phenomena.